It doesn't look like it, but this is a computer. And these other gadgets are the devices we use to test our keyboard's PCBAs before they get assembled onto the actual keyboard. But how does this all work? And why are we doing this again? PCBAs can be complicated. If we take a look at the PCBA of the Race 2 keyboard, it's made of all these different components that are soldered onto the board. Sockets for the keyboard switches, the LEDs for the backlight, the microcontroller, and all of these tiny wires that connect all the components together. Just for those who don't know the difference between a PCB and a PCBA, a PCB is the blank circuit board with no electronic components attached, while a PCBA is a completed assembly that contains all of the components needed. To ensure that these PCBAs work, all functionality and interfaces must be tested. If we find something that doesn't work, then we'd know which part of the assembly made this error and we can fix it and prevent it from happening again. Time is of the essence. The sooner we check the electronics, the sooner we can assemble the keyboards and ship them to you. That's what the devices we showed you in the beginning of the video are for. As an example, here's the setup that we have implemented in our PCBA factory in China to test the PCBAs of the Race 2 keyboard. Here we have a test jig, which is an adapter for the PCBA we want to test. The jig contains a lot of test pins, which connect exactly to test points on the PCBA. Those test points then connect to an interface tester box, which runs a special firmware, and is then connected to a computer running a Python test script. This test is used to program the bootloader, flash the firmware, and check each and every functionality of the PCBA, such as the power regulator, the USB flash memory access, the I2C and SPI interface to the neuron, the CCI and CC2 input lines, the RGBW backlight LED matrix, the underload drive interface, the module interface, the reset and bootloader push button lines, and other things. If there is anything failing, we see a red text on the computer screen, meaning repairman is needed. We also test the connectors of the USB-C cable for both sides and continue with the tests. What you've seen is just one of the test jigs for the key scanner PCBA of the Race 2 keyboard. It's the biggest test jig we have, but it's not the only one. As you may or may not know, the Race 2 keyboard has 7 PCBAs. 2 for the key scanner, 1 on each side. 2 for the underglow, 1 on each side. 2 for the RF gateway, again 1 on each side. And 1 for the neuron, which means 7 test jigs. This is the test jig for the neuron. Inside this jig, there's a programming interface that allows us to flash the data on the neuron's microcontroller. It then has a functional test, but we don't use the jig for that. It's simply connected to the tester box using USB-C cables. And since this is done by human interaction, it is the most time-consuming functional test. That tester box is then guided by a Python script from our mini computer. The test jig for the underglow PCBA is the simplest. It doesn't need a computer, but just the tester box that sends all the needed commands to measure the power consumption of each LED, and then tests each and every one of them. And the last jig is for the RF PCBA, which is the most complicated test because we need to test the battery charging, battery monitoring, the communication over wires, and the communication over wireless. Besides the jig, computer, and interface tester box, it has its own programming board. For us to test the battery charger functionality without actually using a keyboard, we simulate the keyboard consumption by using 2 LEDs assembled in the interface tester box that draws more or less the same amount of current that a keyboard would draw. I've only really just shared with you the surface level of what goes on in the testing phase of the electronics. The team have gone through great lengths in making the different test setups for all the PCBAs of our keyboards. All these PCBAs are required so the keyboards can work wirelessly via RF and Bluetooth, and wired. Check out this video if you want to know how we made it happen. It wasn't an easy task.